Hello students. Now we are going to consider an exemplar problem. Exemplar problem 7.17. Okay, I'll read the problem. It's a not even problem, it's kind of conceptual question. Can the instant, it is from the chapter alternating current. Okay, can the instantaneous power output of an AC source ever be negative? Instantaneous power of an AC source ever be negative? Can it be negative? Can the average power output be negative? So two things are asked. Instantaneous power, can it be negative? You will have to think and answer this question. Not just like that you can answer. Instantaneous power. Instantaneous power. Is it possible for instantaneous power to be negative? What about average power? Can average power be negative? That is the question. So we see how to proceed. For that you should know a little bit of waveform diagrams in alternating current chapter. Also you should know some expressions. See, if you have V as V naught sine omega t, we'll take the simplest case. I as I naught sine omega t, let's say, provided it's a resistor. Or we start with V naught sine omega t first. Let's say for a voltage source, the voltage varies according to this. You can't straight away write I is equal to I naught sine omega t unless there is only resistor in the circuit. If something else is there, inductor, capacitor, then phase difference will come into the expressions. So let's say that for an AC source, V is V naught sine omega t. Let us consider a resistive circuit. Resistive circuit. Then I will be I naught sine omega t. Can you say why? Why? Because in an alternating current containing only resistance, voltage and current will be in phase with respect to, will be in phase with respect to each other. Meaning they will be in phase means phase difference zero. So V naught sine omega t, I naught sine omega. The instantaneous power P is VI. So multiply these two. Power is V into I, V naught sine omega t, this is instantaneous power, I naught sine omega t. So multiply V naught I naught sine square omega t. Okay, sine square omega t. So sine square omega t, if you draw graph, the graph will come like this. Let's see power and time. Because it is square here, there is no negative sign. So here you do not have instantaneous power negative, because sine square term is there. Sine omega t means it can be positive or negative. Sine square omega t, power is only positive, there is no negative, provided the AC contains only resistance. Now consider an inductive circuit. Inductive. In inductive circuit, current will lag behind the voltage. Sine omega t minus pi by 2. Inductive circuit, you recollect the phasor diagram, IVL. This is 90. Current lags behind the voltage by 90. Or you can write minus I naught cos omega t. I is equal to minus I naught cos omega t. This is voltage, this is current, the circuit contains only inductor. Only inductor. So instantaneous power we'll calculate. So V naught sin omega t, I minus I naught cos omega t. This is minus V naught I naught sin omega t cos omega t. Can write as multiply and divide by 2, 2 sin omega t cos omega t, so sin 2 omega t. Minus symbol is there. So sin 2 minus, of course it is there. Minus of sin 2 omega t can be negative also, positive also, if you know how to draw the graph. See, first you draw sin 2 omega t. This is power. It look like sine function only. Only thing, the spacing will be little different. This is plus sin 2 omega t. Minus means you have to consider everything should be the negative one. Okay, this should come begin. Should be minus sin 2 omega t. How do you check this? For example, when time t is 2 pi by omega, or when time t is equal to t, let's say small t equal to t. So sin 2 omega t is 2 pi by omega, omega omega will cancel, sin 4 pi, which would be 0. Minus V naught I naught by 2 will be there, but sin 4 pi would be 0. This is minus 2 sin omega t graph, instantaneous power and the time. This should be equal. I haven't drawn them equal. You will have to flip it about the x-axis. This will come down, this will go up, this part will come down, this part will go. So you see, power is negative also, instantaneous power. So when time, this is the frequency will change. So when time t is capital T, what? Sin value will be 0, because sin 4 pi will be there. 2 omega capital T is 2 pi. Like that you can find out the values of the peaks also. It is possible for it to have negative. Is it okay? Normal graph, what do you have? Sine graph, minus sine theta. This will be 2 pi. This is one cycle. Then there will be two such waveforms compressed from the physics point of view, I am telling. So this is minus V naught I naught by 2. Sin 2 omega t. So negative is possible. Similarly, circuit containing only capacitor, this will be plus sin cos omega t. So plus cos omega t. So V naught I naught by 2, that is capacitive current will be capacitive circuit, I sin omega t plus pi by 2. So you will have plus sin 2 omega t, as I have already drawn here, right? You can even check, this will be t, this will be t by 2, this will be t by 4. So you can check it. You put t as t by 4. So sin 2 omega 2 pi by 4. 2 pi by omega by 4. Omega omega will cancel, 4 and 4 will go, sin pi, which is 0. So this is pi. you are getting sin pi. But time t is t by 4. Like that you can even verify for the other waveforms also. So what is the conclusion? It is possible for instantaneous power to be negative. Agreed? Then go to average power. Average power. See, P average. P average. EV, IV, cos phi. EV means E virtual, RMS. IV means I virtual. Again, RMS value of the current. Cos phi. What is phi? Phase difference. Phase difference. So now you can see this is P average. EV positive. We never write RMS value negative. RMS value cannot be negative for both voltage and current. So this is also positive. But what about cos phi? For any particular value of phi, cos phi can be both positive and negative. So it seems as if P average can also be negative. But you think little bit more deeply. Suppose if it is resistive circuit. Resistive circuit. Phi is zero. Inductive circuit. Inductive circuit. Only inductor, pi by 2. Phi is pi by 2. Suppose there is also a resistor in the circuit, phi will not be pi by 2. It will be less than pi by 2. But it is maximum value here is only inductor plus pi by 2. Capacitor, I, VC, minus pi by 2. Take this angle this way. Capacitor minus pi by 2. Right? This is pure resistor, pure inductor, pure capacitor. You see the values are phi is 0, pi by 2, minus pi by 2. What about LR circuit, CR circuit, LC circuit, or even LCR series circuit? Now let us consider LR circuit. LR. All from phasor diagrams. Okay? See LR. VR, this is I, this is VL. Phase would be resultant voltage, net voltage. This is phi, less than pi by 2, LR. LC, so this is phi. Phi is less than pi by 2 numerically. Okay? So it can go from minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. Considering everything. So phi value can go whatever may be the components in the circuit. Phi value can be from minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. Let's say minus pi by 2. Then what will this cos phi? Cos minus pi by 2. That is only capacitor alone. But cos of negative theta will be cos theta. Numerically, this will be cos pi by 2. Please remember, cos minus theta is cos theta. Even function. If you want to use mathematical terms, even function. So, whatever is the value of phi, unless there is this restriction from minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2, including pi by 2. If it is, for example, if the phase difference is say 100, cos 100 will be negative. So, in that case, P average can be negative. But phase difference is from minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. we want to write again in mathematical terms, write like this, phi minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. So P average can only be positive, cannot be negative. Agreed or not? See, so many things you will have to consider. Actually, it is a one mark question probably. So you can, if you refer to books or if you refer to other videos, maybe they will mention only the answer. Instantaneous power cannot be negative. Average power can be, instantaneous power can be negative. Average power cannot be negative. But the explanation is like this. You have to know cos theta is an even function. Some people will argue in terms of r by z, but this is easier. Just think about the cosine function. So what is the answer? Instantaneous power can be negative, whatever may be the components in AC circuit. What about the average power? Can only be positive. Again, whatever may be the components in the circuit. Agreed? Understood? Thank you.